What is up, agents? This is Wrecker, back with another build. Now, this is a really special one because I made this setup specifically for the Golden Bullet event. But I wanted to see the full potential this build can reach when it comes to raw damage numbers. As you can see in the background, we are hitting over 22 million DPS on full stacks. Now, I did reach 24 million at one time, but those are rare numbers. 22 million is what you will be hitting consistently, like 95% of the time. But it's not only the shooting range, you will be able to hit up to 1.2, 1.3 million head crits in combat as well, as per my testing. But what's crazy about all this is that these are all base numbers because we haven't even added Golden Bullet to the mix. And when you do that, it's complete madness, I can assure you. This build is a complete monster and a must-have specifically for this global event. Yeah, it's really, really fun. So, with that being said, let's get into the breakdown. Please like the video, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And by the way, thank you so much for 2,000 subs that we reached, I believe, a day or two ago. So, thank you so much for that. And now, let's begin. Okay, so starting off with the specialization, we are of course running Gunner, getting faster rate of fire, faster reloads, 10% armor on kill, then we do get an armor kit with bonus armor, and then we are getting the Banshee pulls, which only unlocks with the specialization, and since we are running a face tanking build, Banshee pulls is really, really handy. But keep in mind, lastly, you have the right weapon type specced in your weapons tree. For me, that's an SMG and a shotgun. So yeah, that's the specialization we're running. Okay, so starting off with the weapons, the primary weapon I am running to reach that huge DPS for 22-23 million, we are running the Dark Winter SMG. Mine is sitting at 97k base damage, 1380 RPM and a mag of 45. Keep in mind, mine is upgraded to expertise rank 10. That's why you're seeing plus 10% weapon damage. We're getting SMG damage, crit hit chance, and damage to targets out of cover as the third attribute. Of course, we all know the talent that it comes with, it's called Perfect Killer. We're getting an additional 50% critical hit damage on a critical hit kill for 10 seconds, and this keeps refreshing. So as long as you're getting kills, it's gonna keep refreshing, so you'll have it this up all times. So this is an amazing weapon, especially in combination with Golden Bullet. This is a very, very good weapon to run. So yeah, as for my secondary, if I need to as a backup, I'm running my St. Elmo's engine. Of course, it's the best in slot AR presently in the game. So that's what I'm running. Same attributes, we're running damage targets out of cover as the third attribute. It's fully specced out, 23% additional weapon damage from the expertise rank. And yeah, these are the two weapons I'm running primarily. Okay, so starting off with the gear pieces, we are running 4-piece Striker gear set here. We're getting 15% weapon handling, 15% rate of fire, and then the 4-piece gets us the main talent for the gear set. It's called Striker's Gamble. Weapon hits increase total weapon damage by 0.65%, stacking up to 100 times. Now both these percentages, the weapon damage and also the stacks, will be doubled up because we are running the chest and the backpack for this gear set. So instead of 0.65, we're gonna get 1% on each stack, and instead of 100 stacks, we are gonna get 200 because of the chest piece we are running for the gear set. As you see here, it says increases max stacks for Striker's Gamble from 100 to 200 stacks here. That's what the chest piece gives us. For the attributes, of course, it's an all red build. We're running weapon damage, crit hit damage, and crit hit damage mod in here. Second piece for the gear set, yes, we are running the backpack, as I said earlier. All reds, weapon damage, crit hit damage, and a crit hit damage mod in there. And for the talent, as I mentioned earlier, it's going to boost up our 0.65% weapon damage to a whole 1% each stack. So that's what's getting us to 200% weapon damage in conjunction with the chest piece for this gear set. So yeah, that's really good. Same exact attributes on the gloves for the gear set, weapon damage, crit hit chance here. And lastly, same attributes on the gear set knee pads, weapon damage and crit hit damage here. For the holster, I am running the Picaros holster. Of course, that's the best in slot. And also, since it's giving us two core attributes, that's the armor core and the weapon damage 15% along with a minor attribute, this makes it the best in slot here for this setup. And I would highly recommend running this one. So we're getting armor, crit hit damage, and an additional 15% weapon damage here. That's why we're gonna get a little bit of armor. Even though we are running old vets, we still get a tiny bit of armor on top. Lastly, for the mask, we are running the Exotic Coyote's mask here. Old reds, weapon damage, crit hit chance, crit hit damage, and a crit hit chance mod in there. For the talent that it comes with, Skull Pack Instincts, basically it's gonna give you bonus crit numbers depending on the range you're shooting your enemies at. And now, since we are gonna be using this build in very close proximity with an SMG, the only one we are concerned about is the first one, which says 0 to 15 meters plus 25% crit hit damage here. But in case you are shooting the enemies in a longer range, you will get additional crit numbers here. So it depends, you know, what proximity you're playing your build at. But for us, that's a close range build, so that's why we're gonna get the first bonus here. So yeah, this is a very good master run, especially in this build. Best in slot, I would highly recommend running this. So for the skills, as I mentioned earlier, from the gunner specialization, we are unlocking the Banshee balls. That's really, really helpful, especially with this setup, since we are in close proximity, in close range combat. For the mods, I am running 15% radius and 6% skill haste to get the skill back as fast as possible. For the second skill, of course, I am running my Crusader Shield. Of course, this is a close range face tanking build, and this is a very skill that we can run, which is pretty handy. For the mods, I am running shield health mods on the two slots here, and for the third one, I'm running holster region. So those are the mods I'm running. And yes, you won't be using this as much with Golden Mullet especially, but it's very handy to run. So yeah, that's what we're running. Okay, so before we jump into the full overview for this setup, let me show you the stats real quick. On our Dark Winter, we are sitting at 97k base damage, 54% crit hit chance, 139% crit hit damage, 70% headshot damage, and don't forget we also have 10% damage targets out of cover, which isn't listed here. Now, these are really good numbers considering we are running the Coyote's Mask as well. So these are really good base numbers. And also, as my sidearm, I am also running my Orbit. So in case you want to gain even more crit numbers, you can proc that talent on that sidearm. So yeah, just to put it out there. So yeah, these are the stats for our Dark Winter. Okay, so this is the full build, everyone. We are running the Gunner specialization. As my primary, I am running my Dark Winter. For the secondary, I'm running my St. Elmo's Engine. For my sidearm, I'm running my Orbit. Then we are running 4-piece Striker's gear set here, including the backpack and the chest piece, which is gonna boost our damage numbers to basically double 200% weapon damage on full stacks. That's why you saw in the intro and the gameplay, we are able to hit even 24 million DPS on full stacks. So that's just base numbers. And as I said earlier, if you add Golden Bullet to the mix, it's basically madness. So as you will see in the gameplay at the end as well, it's a very, very fun build specifically for this global event. So yeah, for the mask, we are running the Coyote's Exotic Mask. For the holster, we are running the Picaros holster. And yeah, for the skills, we are running the Banshee Pulse and a Crusader Shield. So yeah, let me know what you guys think about it. It's the hardest hitting Dark Winter that I have built so far. So let me know, you guys. By the way, I am already running old reds, but if you are not comfortable with this low armor, you can go with a few blues. Of course, you will be lacking on damage, but not that much. You will still be hitting very, very hard. So feel free to add in more blues in this setup if you prefer to. But for me, this is working fine, especially with the Golden Bullet. You're hitting them and melting the enemies so fast that you even, you know, the enemies won't even get the time to, you know, shoot you back. So yep, that's basically it. So let me know what you guys think in the comment sections, if you like it, if you like it or not. And like the video and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. By the way, thank you so much for 2000 subs here. It's a very tiny goal for me. It's very big though. So thank you so much for all the support I've been getting. And I'll see you in the next one. Enjoy the gameplay. See ya.
Thank you.